Good day and welcome back. Today we're going to talk about the last topic in chapter 1, uncertainties in measurements. So at the end of this video, you should be able to calculate the uncertainty or the error in a derived quantity, and also you should be able to write a derived quantity with the correct number of significant figures. First, we're going to look at the calculation of the uncertainty. It can be categorized into two cases. First is the addition or the subtraction, and second is the multiplication or the division. Let us look at one example from the trial of SMK Yu Hua in 2020, which involved the addition or the subtraction of the data. You are given with the length and the width of a rectangular shape of the wood, which has the error of 0.1 cm for each of the length and the width. So the plus minus of 0.1 cm is the uncertainty, or the error that could be expected from the measurement of the length. First of all, you can calculate the perimeter as usual, which is equal to 2 times the total of the length and the width, and you should obtain the value of 43 centimeters. So now we are going to determine the uncertainty or the error of the perimeter, which is equal to the sum of the error in the primary data based on the formula. We have the perimeter is equal to the 2 times of the length plus the width. So to calculate the absolute error, it is also equal to 2 times the total error of the length and the width. So we have 2 multiplied 0.1 plus 0.1, which is equal to 0.4 centimeter, which is the expected error in the calculation of the perimeter. So here you always need to remind yourself to round off the error to the one significant figure. In the end, you can express the perimeter is equal to 43.0 plus minus 0.4 centimeter. So here, you also need to make sure that the value of the perimeter should have the same decimal places as the error. Next, we're going to talk about the calculations which involve the multiplications or the divisions. Let us reuse the same questions that we're going to find out the area of the wood measured. So the area of the rectangular wood can be determined by the product of the length and the width. So here you can calculate the area is equal to 112.14 centimeters squared. For the uncertainty, we have the sum of fractional error are equal for the data that derived through multiplications or divisions. So fractional error can be calculated by the formula of the uncertainty divided by the value itself. For example, in this case, we have the error of the area divided by the area is equal to the error in length divided by length plus the error in the width divided by the width. So substitute in all the values and you should obtain the error of the area is equal to 2.15 centimeters squared. And remember to round off the value to one significant figure where the error of the area is equal to 2 centimeters squared. So in the end, we can express the area of the wood is equal to 112 plus minus 2 centimeters squared. So take note on the value of the area has the same decimal places as the error, which is 2 centimeters squared. So now we're going to look at another question from trial paper of SMK Yu Hua in 2015. For these questions, the power loss in a resistor is calculated using the formula of V squared over R. The calculations involve the divisions and also the indices, which is the power of 2. You are given with the percentage uncertainty, which is 2.5% for the potential difference and 4% for the resistance. So the percentage uncertainty is actually the formula of the fractional uncertainty multiplied 100%, and you can check the formula as below. So here we're going to apply the same thing in the previous discussion, except that for the variable of the potential difference, we have the V is to the power of 2 in the formula. So in calculating the uncertainty, we have 2 times the error of the potential difference divided by the value. So this is similar as something we have the formula of V multiplied V divided by R. So we have the fractional error of the power is equal to 2 times the fractional error of the potential difference plus the fractional error of the resistance. So since the question here is only asking about the percentage uncertainty, so just put in the value and in the end, you should obtain the percentage uncertainty of the power is equal to 9%. So to summarize the calculation of the error, if the calculation involves addition or subtractions, you can calculate the absolute error simply by adding all the errors involved in the calculations. For the derived data that involve multiplications or divisions, we need to apply the formula of the fractional error of the derived data is equal to the total of fractional error in the formula. So now we're going to talk the next topic, which is about the significant figure for the derived data. So we have the primary data or the measurement values obtained from the questions or the experiment. So physics is very particular with the number of significant figure. So if the calculations of the derived data involve addition or subtractions, we need to focus on the decimal places of the derived data, which should be the same as the primary data with the least number of decimal places. If the calculations involve multiply or divide or the operations of the trigonometry, we need to make sure the significant figure of the derived data should be the same as the primary data with the least number of significant figure. Let us try one question also from trial paper of SMK Yu Hua in 2022. You are given with the length and the width of the strip of paper. If you want to calculate the perimeter of the strip, so the calculations only involve the addition or the subtractions. So the final value of the perimeter should have the same decimal places as the primary data with the least number of decimal places, which is the 22.3 centimeter that has one decimal place. So here the perimeter should be equal to 47.1 centimeter. And if you want to calculate the area of the paper, you need to make sure the significant figure should be the same as the primary data with the least number of significant figure, which is also referred to the length in this case that has three significant figure. So in the end, we should write down the answer of the area as 37.5 centimeters squared, which has three significant figure. So that's conclude my discussion today. If you have any questions, you can leave it in the comment section below. Also, do leave a like and subscribe my channel. I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.